As mentioned on the outset, what we're going to focus in on is some of the common libraries and tooling that you're going to use when it comes to working down the path of data science. And so along those lines, we're going to take a look at a really common library known as Pandas. Now, sorry to disappoint right up front, sadly, this has nothing to do with the bears. I know I was disappointed when I first found that out. But rather, it's a library that has a couple of very common utilities that you'll be using to help work with, manage, and manipulate the data as you start to analyze it. So what is Pandas? Pandas is an open source BSD licensed library, and it's really geared towards high performance and familiar data structures. That what you're going to notice in here is that we're going to have a series library that's going to be a little bit like a list, only gives us a couple of additional tools as well. And we're also going to see a data frame where if you've played around with Excel or maybe a relational database, that you'll feel very comfortable inside of a data frame. So first up, what is series? Well, series is very similar to a Python list. That what it's going to be is a single dimensional array of objects where I have all of my values sitting there, and they'll have some form of an index. One big difference, however, between a series and a list is the fact that we can set our index to really be whatever it is that we might want. By default, it's going to be zero-based, but if you do need some level of control over that, you can have that as opposed to an index, which is always going to be zero-based. Now, to create a brand new series, what you're going to do is use the constructor. So if you've already played around with classes before, you'll know that you go ahead and call this just like you would a normal method, and then pass in the appropriate items. And you'll notice that when you get right down to it, what we're doing here is we're really actually just converting in a list into a series. So you'll notice the square brackets here. That's what we're using to indicate a list typically. So we're actually converting this into a series. The other thing that I want to highlight here is you'll notice this little PD right here. And you might be wondering, okay, well, what is PD? Commonly, when you import in the Pandas library, you'll rename this as PD, PD being short for Pandas. Now, if you've seen me do other videos, you may know the fact that I really don't like single and two and three letter variable names or otherwise. That to me, it's just not, it's not necessarily as clear as to what it might be. That being said, I will always go with convention. So convention always overrides my own personal opinion because, well, I have opinions on everything. But the community has decided that when we use Pandas, that we'll go ahead and abbreviate this as PD. And so I follow right along with that. And I do recommend that you do the same, that whenever there's a convention, you should go ahead and fall in line there. Because after all, it's not just going to be you that will be looking at your code, but it's frequently going to be other Python developers as well. And you want to make sure that they know what it is that you've been up to inside of your code. So while I'm not necessarily a fan of one and two letter variable and namespace names, I'll still go ahead and use PD because, again, that's the convention. So you'll notice here we can go ahead and set all of this up. When we go ahead and display this, it will then show up as just simply that little list right there with the index. And you're also going to notice that if I want to go access a particular item, I can use the normal index functions. So here is my airports with two, just like that. I can do a for loop to loop through each one of those. So if I print all of those out, you'll notice that I'll get Seattle, Tacoma, Dulles, London, Heathrow, and Schiphol down at the very bottom. Okay. Let's turn our attention now to data frames. And I would say that this is probably the most common data type that you'll be using when you're getting in and playing around inside of anything that's data science-y. A data frame is a two-dimensional data structure. And if you've played around inside of a database, if you've played around inside of a spreadsheet, you're going to feel very much at home here. Because what you're going to notice is that we have columns and we have our rows, and our columns are going to have names. So you'll notice that we've got name here, we've got city here, we've got country all the way on the end there. We've got our normal columns just like we would expect. You're also going to notice, again, kind of similar more to a database than maybe to a spreadsheet, that we'll also have a column that will be our index. And you'll also notice that you'll have the ability to control that. By default, it's going to be zero-based, but if maybe I'm importing in from somewhere else, maybe from a table, maybe from a CSV file, maybe there's already IDs that have been set, that I could go in and identify, hey, this is the column that I want you to use as an index, rather than doing the zero-based there. So you do get the ability to control that. If you want to create a data frame, what you're going to notice is that we'll use, again, a constructor, but effectively we're going to convert a list of lists into our data frame. So I want to highlight just this item right here, where you'll notice that we've got Seattle-Tacoma, which is the name of the airport. You'll notice that we've got the city, which is Seattle, and then we've got the country, which is USA. And then you'll notice the next list down below that, I'll highlight that one in blue here. And you'll notice on that one that we've got Dulles, we've got Washington and USA. So again, we've got the name of the airport, the city and the country. So each one of those is an individual list. We're going to take all of those together, convert that into a data frame, and the result is going to wind up being that little table that you're seeing right there. So you'll notice that Seattle-Tacoma, Dulles, London Heathrow, Schiphol, and Changi all become our individual airport names. Just imagine, if you will, that Changi was added onto there, even though it just wasn't listed in the code above. You'll notice the cities, and then you'll also notice the countries. So what happened is we took those lists and we converted that into a table structure. But what I also want you to notice is the column names there. The column names are, quite frankly, not overly helpful. That I got column names of 0, 1, and 2. 0, 1, and 2 don't tell me anything. And not only that, but dealing with data where everything depends on position can get really tricky because you have to be really careful about things moving around and so forth. So whenever we can identify something based on name, that's typically going to be the way that we want to do it. So rather than going with those numbers that we see by default, let's instead identify what our column name should be. So you'll notice the last parameter there, which is our columns. So now when we run this bit of code, now we'll actually wind up with the column names. So you'll notice that we've got name, we've got city, and we've got country. You're going to notice that there's a lot of tools that are available to us inside of the data frame. And we're going to take a look at those in the next couple of videos. But for now, this is how we go in and create the items. Let's get in and take a look at a couple of real quick code demos so we can see this in action.